Hey guys, what is up? Welcome to my channel. For today's video, I am going to be sharing with you my top 5 pink eyeshadow palettes. So if you want to see what they are, then just keep watching. Hey guys, if you're new here, my name is Morgan. I am a product knowledge enthusiast. I just love knowing anything and everything about all the new makeup on the market and sharing my thoughts with you guys. Because of that, I have accumulated quite a lot of eyeshadow palettes. So I've started this new rainbow series where I share my top 5 of every colored eyeshadow. So far, we're pretty early into the series. So I only have my top 5 purple eyeshadow palettes. So now we are moving on to pink. Now what qualifies as a pink eyeshadow palette for me is that at least like 80% of the shadows are pink and the rest are complementary tones of pink. I think when I did the purple one, I was a little bit too strict. Basically, I was like, every shadow has to be purple for it to be included in here. I was a little bit more relaxed. And this was a lot easier than I thought it was gonna be because I was like, I don't really wear pink eyeshadows very often. But that is a total lie. I wear pink eyeshadows all the time. And you know what counts as pink eyeshadows? Rose tone shadows. Do you know what I love? Rose tone shadows. Do you know what I have a lot of? Rose tone shadows. So this was really easy. So let's get into the first palette. These are not in any particular order. They're just alphabetical by the brand, because that makes the most sense to me. We're gonna get into the first one, which is the one that I'm currently wearing. This is the brightest palette of today's video. You'll see the rest are a little bit more wearable, but this one's the bright one. If you want hot pinks and you want to save some money, get great value, great price, you need to try the BH Cosmetics Mimosa palette. This is so awesome. Now, if you're new to my channel, I have a real taste for expensive luxury eyeshadow formulas. I feel like I can really tell the difference, but BH Cosmetics really does not come to play. They have, in my opinion, the best formulation for the best price. I'm like fooled. These are definitely high-end quality shadows and you can get them on sale for dirt cheap. Anyways, we have the Mimosa palette. So in this palette there are 16 shades. As you can see, not every shade here is pink. We have some complementary orange tones, a yellow tone, a slightly lilac tone. But you couldn't run away from the fact that this is a pink palette. Today I played mostly with the pink eyeshadows. I have, let's see, Bottomless, Guava, Pomegranate, Chilled, and Fizzy to create this look. I did film it for a reel, so it should be up on my Instagram very soon. But yeah, if you're looking for really great hot pink eyeshadows that aren't hard to work with, that aren't hard to blend, because I find a lot of times with hot pink shadows, if you want the pigment, they're gonna be hard to blend. These are great quality if you're looking for that for a good price. I definitely recommend this. The shimmers in here are also really stunning. There's some pretty complementary tones. But again, going back to what my favorite part about this palette is you get very vibrant pink tones that aren't hard to work with. Very easy to work with. I really don't know how BH does it at this price point. The only flaw I would say about this palette is that multiple shades look very close to each other. They kind of blend to be one color, so you're not gonna get a lot of variation in the tones here. If you're playing with the pink tones, they're all gonna show up as a hot pink on the eyelid, but if that's the look that you're going for, this is really fantastic, and for the price, I'm not gonna knock it. Really great palette, one of the best pink palettes I have in my collection, and I wanted to share that with you guys. Moving on to the second palette. This one is definitely the most wearable of today's video, but I love it. It's so pretty. The tones are so soft, very romantic. Would be great if you're going for more of a pinky look for a wedding. And best part, it's quite affordable. This is probably the last affordable option that I have, so brace your wallets. But this is the ColourPop Blush Crush palette. This is a 9 PM palette. All of these are blushy tones. And I mean, blush is pink, so I'm putting it in this video. This one is so pretty. It's a good formula from ColourPop and it's very wearable. So maybe if you're thinking of how can you incorporate pink tones in your collection without feeling like this, like how I look, I think that this one is a great one to start off with. You guys, pink tones are so beautiful and soft on the eyelids. They look more natural than you would think, especially when you pair them with a corresponding pink blush. I'd almost use this shade as a blush. I think you guys would really like this if you're looking for a blushy toned palette. This one is one of my favorites and one of the most wearable from ColourPop. It's definitely one of the more popular ones. I believe you can get this one at Ulta still. Super nice. Love it. All right. I could not put this palette in today's video. This is the Charlotte Tilbury Instant Eye Palette in the shade Pillow Talk. So it's based around Charlotte Tilbury's famous Pillow Talk shade, which is a light wearable rosy pink kind of color. So as you can see, not every shade here is pink. We have a little bit of pinky peaches. We have a little bit of like raspberry pinks. We have some browns, which we're gonna pretend that's not here. Anyways, I love this for a great wearable rosy look. You can even go a little bit more intense. This was the palette that I actually wore for my wedding day. When I got married, I was looking for a bridal pinky kind of look, and I went with this guy. I actually went a little bit more pink than normal, but I'm me, you know? But anyways, I love the quality in here. I find that with these 12 pan palettes from Charlotte Tilbury, they tend to have a lot better quality. Okay, maybe not a lot, I'm exaggerating, but I feel like the quality in here is as good as the highest level of quality in the Charlotte Tilbury quads. For some reason, she just does a great job with the formulas here, and I love these rosy tones. So if you like that kind of eye, you like the Charlotte Tilbury style look, you will really enjoy this one. I highly recommend it. One of my favorites. Now, when I first bought it, I wasn't moved by it. I thought it was nice, whatever. As time has gone on, I've really learned to appreciate those rosy pinky tones. So this has just creeped up to become one of my top five pink palettes. Okay, our next palette. I wasn't sure if this qualified as a pink palette, but it totally does in my eyes. And I absolutely love the Natasha Denona Love palette. Now this one, I'm not gonna lie, it's not her best formulation, but I just really love playing with the tones in here. And the quality is still very, very nice, but it's not the best, I'm not gonna lie. However, I still love this. I still think it's good quality, and I really like the color combinations in this one, which has led this to actually become one of my most used Natasha Denona palettes, believe it or not. I don't want to say I use it all the time because that would be impossible for me, but I use it a lot compared to my other Natasha Denona palettes. So the bottom row is really what screams pink here, and then you have some corresponding tones. You of course have a couple of purples, whatever. It is a pink palette in my eyes and I love it. It came out for Valentine's Day a couple of years ago, and because I love pinks and purples so much, this has quickly become one of my favorite palettes, one of my most used. So I still recommend it. I still think it's a great value for Natasha Denona, and I've had a lot of fun with the looks that I could create. I find myself constantly creating a look with a pink crease and one of the purples all over the lid. It just always turns out that way with this palette for some reason, but you can get some really pretty truly pink romantic kind of looks with this guy. Definitely recommend it. It's a palette that you kind of either love it or hate it, and I love it. Okay, I seem to have been talking a lot about this palette recently. It just has become so relevant in all of the recent video ideas that I've had, but I cannot deny it in this video. The Pat McGrath Divine Rose 2 palette obviously is one of my favorite pink palettes. Let's start off with the packaging here. I did get the limited edition chrome pink packaging, and again, this is like not truly 100% pink, but the tones that are in here are made to complement pink, so we are gonna count it as a pink palette. I mean, I don't want to talk about this too much because I've featured this so much in my channel in general, featured it so much recently. I've been wearing it a lot. It's my most used Pat McGrath palette at this current moment. We know Pat McGrath has a lot of pink palettes. I knew I wanted to put one Pat McGrath palette in, and it was definitely this one. No brainer, I thought of it right away, but then I was looking up through my palettes. Dang, Pat McGrath has a lot of rose-toned pinky palettes. Like, she puts out a lot, but this one is definitely my favorite. I really like the Divine Rose 1, but that one is a little bit more subdued. I find myself having a lot more fun with the Divine Rose 2, so I wanted to put that in this video. You have a lot of different fun textures, finishes, really great pigmented, deep mattes. I mean, I don't know. Are you a Pat McGrath fan? I'm assuming you are if you're on my channel, so I don't feel the need to explain myself any further with that one. And just like that, we've hit the top five. While I hate videos being so short, I also really want to keep it very intense for me and keeping it only at five. So I did have to put in an honorable mention because I couldn't help myself. Now this one, I'm not even sure if it qualifies as a pink. You let me know what you think, but I've already done purple and I've already done pink, and this kind of bridges between a purple and pink palette, and I just wanted to mention that it's one of my favorite palettes within the purple pink category, so that's why we're doing an honorable mention, and that is the Huda Beauty new nude palette. Remember when this came out and we were like, this is not nude, like it's definitely not nude, and I remember thinking it's like a pink palette, so I'm considering it to be a pink palette, but obviously you have some warmer tones, some purple tones, but I just wanted to talk about it because it's a gorgeous palette, so we're putting it with the pinks today. Very soft romantic looks that you can get with it, kind of leaning a little bit more matte pastel, and one of my favorite parts of Huda Beauty are the textures that she adds, just the variety. You have a pressed glitter, you have a couple textures, metallics, you have shimmer, you have mattes, and I really like this one. I really like the formula, I really love the color story, so I really like that one. Okay, there we have it, you guys. Those are my top five pink shadows, plus an honorable mention. If you have any pink eyeshadow palettes that you love and would like to recommend to others, please put it down in the comment section. And I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Let me know what color you would like to see next. If you guys aren't subscribed to my channel already, I would love it if you would consider taking the time to do so. And I will see you all in the next one. Bye, guys. Have a good one.